जार्धन संपदा गौरांगर सेदाने भक्ति रस गौरांगेर मधुर लीला जार करने प्रवेशिला हृदय निर्मला भेलो जे गौरांग नाम लो तार हो प्रेम दो लीला तारे स्पुरे
गौरांग गुणित झुरे नित्य लीला तारे स्पुरे
से दाना भक्ति अधिकारी
से जाना भक्ति अधिकारी
गौरांग रसंग गणे नित्य सिद्ध कोरे माने
गौरांग रसंग गणे नित्य सिद्ध कोरे माने
से राय ब्रजेंद्र सुत
से जाय ब्रजेंद्र सुत
श्री गौड़ा मंडल भूमि जय बाजाने चिंता मणि
श्री गौड़ा मंडल भूमि जय बाजाने
तारा होय ब्रज भूमे
वा होय ब्रज भूमे
गौर प्रेम रसार्णवे जे तरंगे देव डुबे
गौरंग
मोदे तार तंग चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय जय नित्यानंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
पावन हरि नाम संकीर्तन की
जय
अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद
की
श्रील प्रभुपाद की
जय
श्री श्री गौर निताय की
जय
श्री राधा कुंज बिहारी की
जय
ओम अज्ञान तमिरंदस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण वी वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द चैतन्य चरितामृत मध्य लीला सिक्स्थ चैप्टर आई विल शो यू द पावर पॉइंट दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग नाउ Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhyalila, 6th chapter, Lord Chaitanya delivers Sarva Bhattacharya, where we are in, I think text number 191, okay. So yesterday we discussed this one, today we go further today. Lord Chaitanya explains the Atmarama verse. So the picture that I have shown here, is the four Kumaras who are impersonless, becoming devotees by smelling the... See, there's a tulasi leaf in Lord's lotus feet. Did you observe that? Yeah. One of them is watching the tulasi, one of the four Kumaras. One is seeing the Lord's beautiful face. Others are seeing the... See, one of them is stunned, seeing the Lord's beautiful flow, four blue arms and his Mukut and Kundal and everything. In this way, the four Kumaras became devotees. The other picture is the Shukadeva Goswami, who became a devotee by hearing those two woodcutters in the forest who were disciples of Vedas. And then later on, he heard Srimad Bhagavatam and he spoke Srimad Bhagavatam. So this verse, Atma Ramascha Muniyo, fits very well for him. He was an Atma Ram and he became a very, very famous devotee amongst all the devotees. It's mentioned in the Bhagavatam. He became very Vaishnava Janapriya, it is said. Then we will read further today, 199 to 215, Lord Chaitanya displays his forms of Vishnu and Krishna to Saurabha Bhattacharya. You will find Lord's descent in this world, even when Krishna descended, he spoke Bhagavad Gita and he showed Vishwarupa Darshan to Arjuna, isn't it? Similarly to Yashoda, he showed the whole universe within his mouth, in the belly, isn't it? So he gave knowledge also, logically. In fact, he even quotes the rishis also. Guru Parampara also he quotes. Along with the knowledge, he also gave revelation. Similarly, Lord Chaitanya gave knowledge to Bhattacharya and smashed all the illusion and doubts and everything. And then here is a revelation of his Krishna form and Vishnu form. He will reveal now to show his real identity, which is actually definitely his mercy on Saurabha Bhattacharya, because Lord doesn't reveal himself to anybody very easily unless he is very pleased with somebody. So he reveals his form. And then the new Bhattacharya completely surrenders, Lord Chaitanya understanding his true identity and understanding the glory of the Vaishnava philosophy. So that is a big section, 216 to 286. How many? Almost 70 verses. In that there are subdivisions are there. Saurabha Bhattacharya's faith in prasadam and Saurabha Bhattacharya's devotion and composition of two verses. Actually, he composed many, many verses. Two were very prominent. And then he changing the Mukti Pade to Bhakti Pade. So these are the three sections now. Let us proceed now. Bhattacharya Jani Tumi Sakshat Brihaspati Shastra Vyakya Karite Aiche कारो नहीं शक्ति या
श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु सेड माय डियर भट्टाचार्य यू आर एग्जैक्टली लाइक बृहस्पति द प्रीस्ट ऑफ द हेवनली किंगडम इंडीड नो वन विद इन दिस वर्ल्ड हैज द पावर टू एक्सप्लेन द स्क्रिप्चर्स इन सच अ वे
किंतु तुम्हें अर्थ कैले पांडित्य प्रतिभाया श्लोकेर आचे आरो अभिप्राय
माई डियर भट्टाचार्य यू हैव सर्टनली एक्सप्लेन दिस वर्स बाय द प्रोविस ऑफ योर वैस्ट लर्निंग बट यू शुड नो दैट बिसाइड्स दिस स्कॉलरली एक्सप्लेनेशन देर इज अनादर पर्पोर्ट टू दिस वर्स
विच वर्स
आत्मा रामाश्च मुनयो दैट वर्स
भट्टाचार्येर प्रार्थनाते प्रभु व्याख्या कैला तारनवार्त मध्ये एकना चुनिला. So I told him I will give you 9 meanings. Out of that you choose whichever one you want. He is saying that. Without touching upon the 9 explanations given by Bhattacharya. See, you have to take a thorn with a thorn. Similarly, if somebody is a scientist, you bring another scientist there, then immediately the previous scientist is convinced that he is a qualified person, correct? One example comes to my mind. When I was in Bombay Temple, one Srimad Bhagavatam class happened, one TIFR scientist had come. Somehow, somebody brought him there. So he was sitting in the chair. After the class was over, one of the congregation devotees working probably in BRC, I think. So he brought him to Maharaj. Maharaj gave the class. And then he introduced him. Maharaj is a scientist from TIFR. So he just did like this. Maharaj said, oh, you are a very highly qualified person. How did you find the class today? And Maharaj asked. So he said to Maharaj, yeah, it was nice, it was all right, but I have certain doubts relating science and religion, science and spirituality. Then he said two, three things he brought out, some chemistry related things he brought out. And Maharaj said, just a minute, he said, and then looked around. And then Maharaj called one devotee, Vrishabhano Prabhu was there, behind the temple. Maharaj called him and said, he is Professor Bhaskar Hosangadi. And he is a chancellor, no? Head of the department, Mumbai University, in chemistry department. So he said, he can be your very good friend, Maharaj said. Both of us sit, have a discussion, then we will meet again, Maharaj said. So they sat probably for an hour. It's like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Bhattacharya. Isn't it? After that time, after an hour, now when they had their prasad, when they were about to leave, Maharaj again saw him. The same scientist. How did he feel? He said, oh, I was very pleased meeting him. He exactly understands my doubts. He said. So, like we say, you know, hearing from a horse's mouth, we call it. What is the meaning of that, hearing from a horse's mouth? Hearing from an authority whom you respect. Because you know, generally people doubt whether this authority is knowledgeable or not. How much is his vastness of knowledge? How much is his depth of knowledge? How much is his own understanding? How much, or is his knowledge superficial, correct, no? So therefore, when he quoted examples from chemistry, then he could immediately connect with that. Physics and chemistry, he quoted many, many examples. Immediately could connect. Similarly, Mahaprabhu is saying him here, okay, you gave an explanation, very smart, you are like Brihaspati, but I am giving you 9 more. Now see here, take them. Atma Ramascha Shloke Eka Dashapada Haya Pritak Pritak Kaila Padera Artha Nishchaya Pritak Pritak. Yeah.
There are 11 words in the Atmaram verse, and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained each word one after the other.
So the purport is giving the split of those words. Tat tat pada pradanye atmarama milaya ashtadasha artha kaila avipraayalaya. Yeah.
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took each word specifically and combined it with the word Atmaram. He does explain the word Atmaram in 18 different ways.
Yeah. First he explained in 9 ways, isn't it? Now 18 different ways. Bhagavan Tara Shakti Tara Guna Tara Guna Gana Achintya Prabhavati Nera Nayaya Kathana. Yeah.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, His different potencies and His transcendental qualities all have inconceivable prowess. It is not possible to explain them fully.
Anyayata sadhya sadhana kari achadana. Veitine hare siddha sadhake ramana.
These three items attract the mind of a perfect student engaged in spiritual activities and overcome all other processes of spiritual activity.
Which are the three items? Otherwise, he is saying, Anjayata sadhya sadhana kari achadana yaitine hare siddha sadhakera mana. Yeah, these are the three things, no?
196.
Yeah. Which are the three? This one? Tara Guna Gana. Correct. That means Lord, His potencies, and His transcendental qualities. These three cannot be understood. They are very inconceivable, and one who tries to, it's not possible to explain them fully. Otherwise, the sadhya sadhana, everything becomes covered over, he's saying. Read that, purport.
Spiritual activities other than bhakti yoga are divided into three categories. speculative activity conducted by the Jnana Sampradaya learned scholars, fruitive activity conducted by the general populace according to Vedic regulations, and the activities of transcendentalists not engaged in devotional service. There are many different branches of these categories, but the Supreme Personality of Godhead, by His inconceivable potencies and transcendental qualities, attracts the mind of the student engaged in the activities of karma, jnana, yoga, and so forth. The Supreme Lord is full of inconceivable potencies which are related to His person, His energies, and His transcendental qualities. All of these are very attractive to the serious student. Consequently, the Lord is known as Krishna, the all-attractive.
Yeah. So you will find, like Saubarimuni, he was a jnani. But after marrying 50 daughters of Mandata, he became a pure devotee eventually, after a long time. And he went back to Godhead. He perfected his life. So therefore you find Muktanam api Siddhanam Narayana Parayana Sudurlabha Prashantatma Kotishapi Mahamani. Like Krishna says, no, Bahunam Janmanamante Jnanavanam Prabhupada. Eventually they will come, because even Karmis Jnani Yogis are also attracted to Krishna, but not in the beginning. In the beginning they are attracted to Krishna's energies for enjoyment. Eventually they come to understand Him, and like that he is saying. Sanakadi Shukha Deva Tahate Pramana. See. Hey Matananartha Karena Vyakhyana. Yeah.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained the meaning of the verse by giving evidence concerning Shukadeva Goswami and the four rishis Shanaka, Sanatana, Sanandana, and Sanat Kumara. Thus the Lord gave various meanings and explanations.
Yeah. So the purport Prabhupada is saying here, Mukta api Lilaya. Vigraham Kritva Bhagavantam Bhajante. Read the translation.
Even liberated persons are attracted by the pastimes of Lord Krishna, and thus they engage in devotional service.
The example is quoting is our Chatushana is four Kumaras. And Shukadeva Goswami. Both examples is quoting. Shuni Bhattacharya Ramane Hai Lachamatkara. Prabhu ke Krishna jani kare apana dikhara. Yeah.
Upon hearing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's explanation of the Atmaram verse, Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya was struck with wonder. He then understood Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to be Krishna in person, and he thus condemned himself in the following words.
If you remember, Gopinath Acharya was telling him that only one who has attained the mercy of the Lord can know Him fully. Correct, no? So that time he challenged him, asking what question? What is the proof that you have attained mercy and I have not attained? So what did Gopinath Acharya say that time? One who has attained mercy will have a very dridamati. He will be very firmly determined about the Lord's supremacy, and he will be surrendered to the Lord. So since you are simply doing tarka vitarka, you have not attained the mercy, neither he told him. But now he is attaining mercy now, because he is understanding Lord Chaitanya's true position, which means Lord Chaitanya could not hide himself anymore to Bhattacharya. Therefore Prabhupada says, for the jnanis and yogis and karmis, the Lord is mystical, and for the bhaktas he is merciful, he says. Why? Because for jnanis, yogis and karmis, Lord always remains a riddle. They can't capture Him. But for bhaktas, He is merciful, means what? He reveals Himself. That means here Lord Chaitanya has decided to reveal His identity to Bhattacharya. Otherwise, how did Bhattacharya find out? Immediately understood that Lord Chaitanya is non-different from Krishna. He was condemning Himself with the following words.
Ihata sakshat Krishna muhi na janiya. Maha aparada kainu garvita haiya.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is certainly Lord Krishna Himself. Because I could not understand Him and was very proud of my own learning, I have committed many offenses.
Yeah, from 199 onwards, up to 215, Lord Chaitanya displays His forms of Vishnu and Krishna. That is a section now. Already we have started the section. He not only, even before Mahaprabhu revealed his actual identity as Krishna and Ram, already he has understood. Amazing, no? And then Mahaprabhu is revealing. Correct. Atma ninda kari laila prabhura sharana. Krupa kari vare tave prabhura haila mana.
When Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya denounced himself as an offender and took shelter of the Lord desired to show him mercy.
Yeah. So when does Krishna show his mercy? When one is very humble. Like you can see, Kunti Manani is saying, you know, she is saying, Katam Pashyema Histriya. What that was? Tata Paramahamsanam Muninam Mamalatmanam Bhakti Yoga Vidanartam Katam Pashyema Histriya. She is saying, my dear Lord, how can a woman like me see you? Huh? You are only seeable by rishis and munis and pure-hearted devotees. Huh? Muninam Amalatmanam, she is telling. So she is saying, they are very high, they can see you. And what about me? I am just an ordinary woman. So what is the heading of the chapter Prabhupada gives? Most intelligent woman. That's the heading of the chapter. One who considers oneself unqualified, that is the qualification for seeing Krishna. One who considers himself very highly accomplished and highly qualified, that becomes a big disqualification for Krishna. Just like the cobbler and the Brahmin. So what did the Brahmin think about himself? He thought himself highly qualified or unqualified? Brahman. Highly qualified. Yeah, he was thinking himself highly qualified. He said, I have done thousands of sacrifices. I have 5,000 disciples. I have conducted this many yajñas. He said, look at my track record and all that. Whereas the cobbler considered himself completely unworthy. Correct, no? So then Lord revealed, Lord accepted cobbler very easily. So we can show many examples for this. For one, Gajendra Moksha prayers. Gajendra Moksha, when Gajendra was caught by the crocodile, you know, of course initially he looked behind to take help from the, you know, relatives and all. They couldn't help him. They were trying to pull him from behind with the tail. They couldn't pull him out. They couldn't help him out. And they were also crying. They were afraid that if we go in the water, then we'll be caught by another crocodile. They were also afraid. Correct, no? Although they had a desire to help, but they had no confidence to come inside the water and help him. So now he understood that they can't help me. Then he thought, I have to fight myself. He fought also. But even after pulling, you know, sometimes he would pull him towards the bank of the lake. Other times he would pull him inside. But who was more victorious? Crocodile. He was a creature of water. He was very strong. Pulled him inside. So that time, you find Gajendra, there is one particular verse which says that he cried tears. And in that tears, he said that, you know, whom can I blame for all my suffering? Atma kritam vipakam viseno. In the similar way, he said, it's all due to my own past karma that I am suffering like this. I am caught by a crocodile. I don't know whether I will be able to maintain my life or I will lose my life. I can't blame anybody. I have to blame whom? Myself. As soon as he thought like that, immediately the remembrance of previous life came to him. That is the point, turning point for him. Even milk drinking brahmachari was showered mercy by Mahaprabhu by his humility. Isn't it? Similarly, there is another verse. Trastosmyakam krapana vatsala dussahogra samsara chakra kadanat grasatam pranita baddhasvakarma virushattamitengri moolam preetopavarga sharanam bhayase kadano. In this verse, Prahlad is telling Lord Narasimha, Trastosmyaham, I am extremely afraid, he is saying. Kripana vatsala dussahogra. It's very intolerable, ugra material world, my Lord. Why? Lord may ask him, is it because the world is having birth, old age, disease and death, due to which you consider it as ugra? He says, no. That is ordinary samsara, he says. I am not afraid of the ordinary samsara. I am afraid of this deadly samsara. Which is it? He is saying, samsara chakra kadanat grasatam pranita. The non-devotees and atheists who are being devoured by maya in this world, they are always critical of you. They criticize you. They always blaspheme about you. And that samsara I don't like, he says. And then Lord Narasimha is asking, So, do you mean to say I pushed you to fall there in the samsara? He says, no. This is what he is saying. Baddhasva karma bir. By my own karma bir, I have become baddha. Can I blame the Lord? No. He says, baddhasva karma bir. Ushattamatengri moolam. Pritopavargarsharanam khaisekam. When will the time come when I'll be able to come to the spiritual world and massage your lotus feet? So again, the same point. Prahlad took responsibility for his own suffering. Gajendra took responsibility for his own suffering. And even the cow and the bull, you know, the bull refused to show a finger to whom? Kali. He took responsibility also. You'll find. Suchakasyapi tad bhavet, he said, no? Dharmam ravish dharmagya. What is that? Dharmosi vrisharupadra yad adharma kritasthanam suchakasyapi tad bhavet, he said. If I point fingers to somebody as the cause of my suffering, if that fellow goes to hell, I will go with him to hell. He said, I don't want to point fingers to anybody. He is just a perpetrator delivering my goods of my own karma. He is an instrument of my past karma. I won't blame anybody, he said. So in this way, those who take responsibility for their suffering without getting into a blame game, such people are revealed by the Lord. Here he is saying, Bhattacharya denounced himself as an offender and took shelter of the Lord. Lord immediately decided to show him mercy.
Nijarupa Prabhu Tare Karayila Darshana Chatur Bhuja Rupa Prabhu Haila Takhana.
To show him mercy, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu allowed him to see his Vishnu form. Thus, he immediately assumed four hands.
Dekaila tare age chaturbhuja rupa pache shyama vamshi mukha swakiya swarupa.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first showed him the four-handed form and then appeared before him in his original form of Krishna with a blackish complexion and a flute to his lips.
Just like what he did for Devaki and Vasudev, correct, na? He showed a four-handed form, he showed the baby form, both Krishna form also he showed.
Dekhi sarvava madandavat karipadi punah uthi stuti kare dui karayudi.
When Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya saw the form of Lord Krishna manifested in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he immediately fell down flat to offer him obeisances. Then he stood up and with folded hands began to offer prayers.
Kutanjali Mudra, yeah.
Prabhu ra kripaya tara sphurila sabha tattva nama prema dana adi varne namahatva.
By the mercy of the Lord, all truths were revealed to Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya and he could understand the importance of chanting the holy name and distributing love of Godhead everywhere.
Shatashloka kaila eka danda nayayite brihaspati taiche shloka napare karite.
So is Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya Shatakam. There is 100 verses he has written. Yeah.
Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya composed 100 verses in a very short time. Indeed, not even Brihaspati, the priest of the heavenly planets, could compose verses as quickly.
And it's called Shushloka Shataka. Yeah. Shunisuke Prabhutare Kailalingana. Bhattacharya Prema Veshe Haila Achetana.
After hearing the 100 verses, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu happily embraced Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, who was immediately overwhelmed in ecstatic love of Godhead and fell unconscious.
Ashustamba Pulaka Shveda Kampa Tharahari.
Ashustamba Pulaka
नाच गाय कांदे पड़े प्रभु पद धरी।
Out of ecstatic love of God, the Bhattacharya shed tears and his body was stunned. He exhibited an ecstatic mood and he perspired, shook and trembled. He sometimes danced, sometimes chanted, sometimes cried and sometimes fell down to touch the lotus feet of the Lord.
All the Ashtasadvika Vikara are manifesting in his body now. He has become a devotee now. He is in an ecstatic mood, he perspired, he shook. So in this way Lord Chaitanya is showing him darshan of Vishnu and Krishna forms.
Dekhi Gopinatha Acharya Harashite Mana Harashita Mana भट्टाचार्य नृत्य देखे हासे प्रभु रगणा।
He started dancing now, yeah.
While Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya was in this ecstasy, Gopinath Acharya was very pleased. The associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu all laughed to see the Bhattacharya dance so.
Actually, in the path of bhakti, when one crosses the bhajana kriya, and then anarthanavritti, when one feels nishtha and ruchi, that time it is said the bhakti devi herself makes the devotee dance. So makes the devotee, it is like a dancing step forward after ruchi onwards. Ruchi, asakti, bhava, prema. Here he is feeling bhava here because of tears welling up in his eyes, hair standing on end, Mahaprabhu's association, embrace of Lord Chaitanya. So now when bhakti devi makes the devotee dance, he completely becomes like a play toy in the hands of Bhakti Mata, like a child in the hands of a mother. So one is completely sold out to Krishna. One loses the external consciousness.
Gopinatha Acharya kahe Mahaprabhu ra prati Sei Bhattacharya ra Prabhu kailaye gati.
Gopinatha Acharya told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, "Sir, you have brought all this upon Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya."
Prabhu kahe tumi bhakta tumara sanga haite. Jagannatha ihare kripa kaila bhala mate.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replied, "You are a devotee. Because of your association, Lord Jagannath has shown him mercy."
So, Mahaprabhu used to divert all the glorification to two people. One is to Jagannath. Like even to Sanatan Goswami, he told, no? You know, he said, "Sanatan, you know, Lord Krishna has..." He told Raghunath Das also. Lord Krishna has... Jagannath has saved, yeah, correct. Whenever he saves, what he will say? Jagannath has saved, he will say. Or he will tell the devotees that by your association you have saved. Either he will say.
Tame Bhattacharya Prabhu Sustira Karila. Stirahaya Bhattacharya Bahustuti Kaila.
After this, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pacified the Bhattacharya, and when he was quieted, he offered many prayers to the Lord.
He became sober now. Jagat nistarile tumi seh alpakarya.
Ama udharile tumi yehi shakti ascharya.
Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya said, "My dear sir, you have delivered the entire world, but that is not a very great task. However, you have also delivered me, and that is certainly the work of very wonderful powers."
Tarka shastre jada me yai che lauha pinda. Ama dravayile tumi pratapa prachanda.
I had become dull-headed due to reading too many books on logic. Consequently, I had become like an iron bar. Nonetheless, you have melted me, and therefore your influence is very great.
Mm. So he's saying that I was a Tarikaga Srigala Sangha Bhai Bhaiukari. I think it'll come, I think, soon. So he said, I had become a dry logician with no bhakti. And such a hard stone like me or iron like me, you have melted my heart.
Stuti shune Mahaprabhu nija vasa aila. Bhattacharya acharya dware bhiksha karaila.
After hearing the prayers offered by Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu returned to his residence, and the Bhattacharya, through Gopinath Acharya, induced the Lord to accept lunch there.
Aradina Prabhu Gela Jagannatha Darshane Darshana Karila Jagannatha Shayothane.
From this verse onwards, new Bhattacharya starts from here. So 216 to 286. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Early the following morning, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to see Lord Jagannath in the temple, and he saw the Lord rise from his bed.
Pujariyaniyamala prasadanna dila. Prasadanna mala paya prabhu harshahela.
So Mahaprabhu received the garland and the Mahaprasad of Jagannath. One important thing to see here, when we were all very new to ISKCON and, you know, Krishna consciousness, if somebody comes and gives you some prasad, you are very delighted. Somebody gives you some sweet rice or halwa. Even halwa is new for us at that time. Correct, no? And even khichdi is very opulent at that time. Isn't it very delightful? But once you spend several years to be delighted by saying prasad or to be delighted by taking darshan, it is only mercy. Because we may become very stereotyped in receiving these things. For example, I had gone to a temple, I had taken a box of sweet prasad. So as soon as I went and gave one devotee, two, three of them didn't want to take it because they have eaten so much sweet and they have had many problems. Because of the sweet, so it becomes like not very attractive. Then I said, okay, take a little. Nowadays I don't take only sweet, I carry some namkeen also. in case there is. So once I took namkeen, when they don't like sweet, I showed them, this is all right, you can take. So I am saying, we sometimes may become overly familiar. Atiparichayat, avagnyat. Whereas you can see, Mahaprabhu daily he goes to see Jagannath. Daily he takes darshan and then Mahaprasad is being supplied to him. He is seeing Mahaprasad with a very great respect and harsha haila. Yeah.
The priest there presented him with garlands and prasadam that had been offered to Lord Jagannath. This pleased Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very much.
Sei prasadanna mala anchale bandiya. Bhattacharya ghare aila. Twarag yukta haya.
Carefully tying the prasadam and garlands in a cloth, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu hastened to the house of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya.
Now you want to give him more mercy now. Already by one installment of mercy, he spoke about the Atmaram verse and defeated all misconceptions. He has woken up Bhattacharya to devotional service. Then the second mercy he gave, by giving darshan of Krishna and Vishnu, and that darshan he gave. Bhattacharya was amazed by that darshan. And then Bhattacharya praised him in 100 verses. Then he gave him third mercy by embracing him. He instilled in his heart, you know, the Ashtasattvika Vikar, love for Krishna. Now Mahaprabhu is not satisfied giving this much mercy, he wants to give even more. So he wants to go to his place and give prasadam and garland to Bhattacharya and give him another one more installment of mercy.
Arunodaya kale haila praburagamana. Sei kale Bhattacharya haila jagarana.
Sei kale Bhattacharya
Yeah.
He arrived at the Bhattacharya's house a little before sunrise, just when the Bhattacharya was arising from bed.
Krishna Krishna Sutaka He Bhattacharya Jagila. Krishna Nama Shuni Prabhura Ananda Badaila Badila. Krishna Nama Shuni Prabhura Ananda Badila.
See, what is the filling of our chitta or our subconsciousness is very vital in the path of spiritual life. Often it is possible for us to consciously do spiritual activities when we are awake. Correct, no? When you are awake, like for example, you may say Vanchakalpatarubhyascha to somebody, and when you see the deity opening, altar opening, you may offer obeisances. But what is in our subconscious mind is much deeper. Like a glacier, if you see, only the tip is seen. Below the water, there is a whole ice, isn't it? That is our subconscious mind. And subconscious mind is coming from the Purva Janma, scripts, as well as how we were brought up by our parents and grandparents and teachers and friends and the books we read and all those things. So, subconscious. So, one fellow knew 20-25 languages he knew. He was going from one place to another. So, in one kingdom when he stayed, anybody who can find out what his language is, then he will be accept the defeat. His mother tongue, if somebody finds out, he will accept his defeat. But nobody could defeat him because he always spoke in all the languages very eloquently. Nobody could find out. But there was one Tenali Ram. Tenali Ram, very intelligent fellow. What he did, it was a very freezing cold season. So he took chill fridge water. He took with him. So the early morning he went, 2:30, he went to his room and took some chill fridge water and sprinkled on his face. Immediately therefore jumped up and shouted in his mother tongue, he gave a gali. And he noted the language. He gave bad word. Later on, in the court, when they all came at 10 o'clock, court assembled, Tenali Raman immediately said, "This is your mother tongue." And he was stunned. How this fellow found out? Because generally what happens when you're walking in the road, if a thorn pricks your feet, generally we go, "Amma! Appa!" Correct, no? And different people say different. Some English people say, "Damn it!" They may say like that, correct, no? Correct, no? Different people say different things. And some people say some bad words also, So many things people say. But if Krishna occupies our chitta, He occupies our subconscious mind, as soon as anything pleasurable or hurting, two extremes, they happen in your life, you immediately say, "Hey Govinda, hey Gopal," or "Hey Krishna, hey Rama," that kind of word will come. Correct, no? So, therefore, here you find, you can imagine the impact of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's preaching on Sarvam Bhattacharya. It has gone into his subconscious mind. That means he did not accept Bhakti Yoga superficially. He accepted Bhakti Yoga wholeheartedly. That is the proof. Krishna says, "Sada tad bhava bhavitaha." He says, "Yo mame asam mudo janati purushottamam sa sarvavid bhajati mam sarva bhavena bharata." So he has wholeheartedly accepted. Therefore, as soon as he got up from the bed, what is the first word he said? Krishna, Krishna. Like that, distinctly he pronounced Krishna's names while getting up. And actually, we all had this experience also. We had never uttered Hare Krishna ever before. Maybe in South India we have sung Govinda Jai Jai, Gopala Jai Jai, or Krishna we have sung. But Hare Krishna was a new thing when you came to ISKCON. But then we observed that within just attending classes for 1 or 2 months, the Hare Krishna became a buzzword in IIT everywhere. Hare Krishna, you see any devotee, Hare Krishna. You are going to take prasadam, Hare Krishna. You are going to sleep, offer obeisance, say Hare Krishna. For everything you say Hare Krishna, you see. Similarly, here also he is saying, Krishna Krishna Svatakahi Bhattacharya Jagila. Krishna Nama Shani Prabhu Ananda Badda. Lord Chaitanya, as soon as he heard the word Krishna's name, he heard, who became very delighted? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very happy. He is getting up chanting chanting Krishna's names. My spiritual master used to give programs in Haridwar. So when Pune devotees were sent headed by our Jivadaya Prabhu and others, you know. So Maharaj was very happy because he said that anybody looking for God, looking for religion, when they come from abroad into India, which is the place they go generally? Rishikesh and Haridwar. Those are the places they go first. Then they may go to other places like Rameshwaram, they may go to Badrinath Kedarnath, they may go to Vrindavan Dwarakanda. Eventually they go. So therefore he said, he wanted to see some preaching happening there. So he himself goes for preaching there. So one place I saw in the big poster of all the Yogi Babas, so his photo was also there. In the yearly meeting, you know, where everybody speaks. So the yogis count him as one of them, one amongst them, because he was a yogi before, you know, in Himalayas and everything. So he also speaks. So when he speaks to them, he knows their mindset. So he sits in the asana. Om. So yogi means one who can prolong the om as long as possible. Sometimes even 5 minutes, 6 minutes also, he can prolong. Of course, for us, beyond 3 minutes, it will be difficult. Even for blowing a shank, we may, you know, take a deep breath and then blow, isn't it? Because that is the one other main practice, pranayama mandal they do. So Maharaj would say, Om, and all the yogis joined, Om. And then Maharaj said, Ajnana temirandasya jnananjana shalakaya. Then he started that prayer. But yogi said, immediately their hearts resonated with him. Correct, no? So, now generally, if you meet also other people outside, they will say, Hari Om, they will say. You say Hari Bol, what they will say? Hari Om. You have seen that? Isn't it? So Bhattacharya also must have been saying something like that. Hari Om or Om or something. But now, what has happened now? Krishna, Krishna, he said. Otherwise earlier, he said Namo Narayana. Correct, no? Namo Narayana, he said. So Mahaprabhu, what he told him? Krishna Matirastu. Now the Krishna Matirastu has happened now. Krishna has entered into the Mati of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Yeah.
As Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya arose from bed, he distinctly chanted, Krishna, Krishna. Lord Chaitanya was very pleased to hear him chant the holy name of Krishna.
Bahire Prabhu Rate Ho Payala Darshana. Aste Vyaste Asikaila Charana Vandana.
The Bhattacharya noticed Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu outside and with great haste he went to him and offered prayers unto his lotus feet.
Yeah. See, both of them are hasty. Correct, no? Mahaprabhu is hasty to give mercy and Bhattacharya is hasty to receive mercy. Correct, no? The word hasty is used in both places. You saw that? See, Mahaprabhu knows well that this personality was a hardcore Mayavadi. Now he is becoming a devotee. So Mahaprabhu is very, very happy. Goes to Jagannath temple, picks up the garland, picks up prasad. So just like any cultivator will be thinking, oh, this boy is picking up devotion service. Let me give him some Mahaprasad. Let me please him. Let me escort him. So in your hasty love, many times you will see your speech may be incoherent sometimes. You have seen that? Because you are very hasty and very eager to... even if you are an angry man, to him you will become very polite. Because you are cultivating is a... You know, you will see that their haste is eagerness to give Krishna's mercy to Bhattacharya. And Bhattacharya is also, he is actually newly transformed from Mayavad to Bhakti Yoga. So, and his heart and mind must have been filled with the thoughts of his conversation with Lord Chaitanya. So the morning he got up chanting Krishna Krishna and he is hastily coming, you see, to...
Vasite asana diya duheta vasila. Prasadana kuli prabhu tarahate dila.
Yeah.
The Bhattacharya offered a carpet for the Lord to sit upon, and both of them sat there. Then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu opened the prasadam and placed it in the hands of Bhattacharya.
Prasadana Paya Bhattacharya Ananda Haila. Snana Sandhya Danta Dvana Davana Yadyapina Kaila. Snana is bath, Sandhya is Gayatri, and Danta Davana means to clean the, So none of it Yadyapina Kaila. Although he had not done all these things.
Bhattacharya is very happy to receive the prasada.
Chaitanya Chaitanya prasade mane rasava jadya gela. Ye shloka pani anna bhakshana karila.
By the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all the dullness in the mind of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was eradicated. After reciting the following two verses, he ate the prasadam offered to him.
What is the dullness? That is smartha buddhi. That is the dullness. Actually, there are two types of people in this world. One are the smarthas, one are Vaishnavas. So the smarthas go by only the external rules, regulations and rituals. And like just like yajnik brahmins, they were chanting the Vedic rituals and offering ahuti in the fire, which is tongue of Vishnu, and the yajna kund is mouth of Vishnu, and Vishnu is just behind their house in the form of Krishna and Balram, asking for some prasad, and they are not arranging for prasad, but here they are busy offering ahuti. It's like imagine if a lady in a home keeps a photo of the husband and she is watching and talking to the photo, and imagine husband has come from the army. After a long time, after one year he has come, coming and battering the door. Oh, my dear wife, open the door. She says, "No, who is disturbing me?" She says, "Don't disturb. I am talking to my husband's photo," she says. Husband only has come here. That's what happened with them, no, Yajna Brahmins. Actually, the Yajna Kund with its fire reaches Lord Vishnu. But here Krishna has come, who is source of Vishnu also. But they could not recognize. This is called smartha tendency. Correct, no? On the other hand, Vaishnavas actually know the letter of the law and spirit of the law, both. For example, say there is a road in which they have written a speed limit as 30 km per hour. Correct, no? So, naturally you have to go in your car at 30 km per hour. Correct, no? Imagine you go in your car at 30 km per hour and you are knocking down all the bikes on the side of the road. Boom, 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 boom. Four or five bikes you knocked out, they all fell and the glass broke. Something got dent and everything. Police will come running. You say, "See, police, 30 km per hour I'm keeping. Speed is maintained. You can't find me because I maintain the speed." If you say, "Okay, speed is maintained, the purpose for which the slow speed is mentioned there, that purpose is defeated." You understand, no? Why they are saying slow? Because a lot of pedestrians come, people come in bike, children keep crossing the road. So you are supposed to go slow so that you don't hit anybody. You are following the, you know, speed limit, but you are hitting, and that is actually defeating the purpose for which the speed limit was kept, correct, no? So therefore, it's called as, you know, following the letter of the law and not spirit of the law. Spirit is not understood. On the other hand, if somebody says, "Oh, I know the spirit of the law," he tells the policeman, police tell me, "I should not hit anybody," correct, no? "I should not hit any vehicle, I should not hit any person," that's all, no? Yes. He goes at 80 km per hour in a big car. Zoom, there he goes. Police catches him. "Hey, what is this?" "See, my speed may be great, but there is not a single person, you know, who is standing on the road. All are running away to the sides, no? I am not hitting anybody." So condition is followed, correct, no? That means, you know, you tell me, did I hit anybody? Tell me. If he says, "Hey, that's not the point. Your driving is so frightening. All people are naturally running away to the sides, isn't it?" So that is also, that person is also breaking, correct, no? He is following the spirit, but not what is not following? Letter of the law is not following. Letter of the law says that the speed limit is 30. So who is right out of the two? Both are wrong, correct, no? So one has to keep both. Follow spirit of the law, letter of the law, both. So smarthas follow which one? Letter of the law. But Vaishnavas follow both spirit of the law and letter of the law. And when something has to be compromised, they know according to Deshkala Patra which one should be compromised. Breaking a lesser rule for a higher rule. They know exactly what is to be done, where, when can we break, and they are aware of that. So therefore you find what made Mahaprabhu so happy was the dullness in the mind of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was eradicated. The dullness was his, you know, mind was stuck in Mayabad, his mind was stuck in Smartha Buddhi, his mind was stuck in impersonal understanding of God. He had no idea of the Shaktis of the Supreme Lord. He was a Shushka Vairagi, dry renunciate. But here Mahaprabhu is watching that as soon as he got up, Krishna, Krishna, that means is becoming blossomed in his consciousness. It's a blossomed consciousness. So, actually, in our progress in spiritual life also, as one becomes less and less sinful and more enthusiastic in hearing about the Lord and associating with the devotees, then one will find that the blossoming nature will increase in a devotee. The devotee blossoms more and more. I have seen in new boys also who come for the classes, when you ask a question, you know, from the answers they give, you can easily say whether they are blossoming or not. Because some of them catch a lower understanding. Some of them catch a higher understanding. Correct? No, they don't. One example I'll tell you. I was telling boys that near Ganeshkind, you know, one very big millionaire from Koregaon Park, you know, he came out of the shop. From the shopping mall there, big one. Came out. While coming, his purse fell off. He's a crorepati. He has a huge car. He bought it and went to Koregaon Park. So one student came, engineering student came. He saw the purse. When he opened it, you know, oh, he found practically there was cash, 4 lakh rupees. Can you imagine? Somehow or other he had withdrawn and kept. He's a rich man. And along with that, there were also a lot of other cards like PAN card and, you know, many bank related things and all were there. Now this boy can do two things. What he can do? He can actually call the person and go to his home, Koregaon Park, and hand over the purse, correct, no? But what this boy did, he thought, I exactly wanted 4 lakhs for my engineering college fee. Yeah? So, I can take this. So, he took the money for paying to the college. And then he also tried to do some forgery and use those cards to get money from the bank. And that is where he was caught. And when he was caught, the man found him, because he told the bank to block these things. What do you call it? Account. So he was caught. Naturally, the boy was put behind the bars. Now I was thinking when I heard this, imagine if the boy was honest. He took this facility of the purse, and went to the, money's also there, he can take auto with the same money, go there and then say, sir, I found this outside this thing. Please kindly take this purse. I saw your name, your address. I am coming and giving you. So that man, gentleman, was so pleased. He would be so pleased, he would say, please take your seat. Come, you know, so much money is there, so much facility is there. You never misused it. I want to know, what's your name? And then, do you have any problem? He may say, sir, I have a little problem of paying fee to the college. The man may say, don't worry, I will take care of your fee. You know, once you take a job, you can pay me back later. Correct? Can't he do or can he do or not? He can do, isn't it? And not only that, when the boy graduates from the college, this man will take him in his company. Because he's a trustworthy fellow. Everybody is looking for trustworthy fellow, isn't it? So in the same manner, all of us in this world, when we come, we get the purse of the human bodily faculty. Human bodily facilities, we are given. What are the facilities in human body? You have the sixth sense. Apart from five senses, you can actually, atato brahma jignasa, you can do. And what other facility? You can do shravanam. You can hear about the Lord, isn't it? You can take darshan of the deities, isn't it? And you can accept a guru, guru like the captain of the boat. And you can prepare yourself to go back to God. All this is like the purse with all the facilities, correct, no? Actually, you have a lot of facilities. Now, who has given you this facility? Krishna has given you. Like the owner is there in Koregaon Park. He owns this purse. Similarly, if we take this body and give it to Krishna, if you hand it over to Krishna, Krishna, you gave me this body, I will use it all for your service. Then what will Krishna do? We become trustworthy in his eyes. Then he will absorb us in Goloka, back. We can go back home, back to God, correct? But what people generally do? As soon as they get the human body with all the facilities, what they do? They take it and then they misuse it. For whose pleasure? Sense gratification. So I was telling this example in one class. Then I asked the boys, what did you understand? So one boy was telling that, he said that, sir, whenever we see money in a purse, we should not keep it, we should give it back. Exactly, he said, if somebody's money, because then they may put us behind the bars and all problems will come, better we give back the money. Anything else you learnt? I asked, you didn't learn anything more. That's all you learnt. And I asked 2-3 boys, and one boy said clearly, he said, sir, the human form of life is very rare and it is a gift given to us by Krishna. Human body is gift Krishna has given us, and what gift do we give back to him? The same gift, along with our free will. I will use my free will to offer it back to you, and we should use it. And then the boy said, just like the boy returned the purse to the owner, he said. That means he has understood well, correct, no? So you will find many times when you talk to people, people catch a lower understanding or a higher understanding, depending on how much they are blossomed in their Krishna consciousness. Some people are very dull in Krishna consciousness, some people are awakened. Therefore, he is saying his dullness in mind was finished. Shushkam paryushitam vapi nitam vadura deshatah praptimatrena bhoktavyam natrakala vicharana. Yeah.
The Bhattacharya said, one should eat the Mahaprasadam of the Lord immediately upon receiving it, even though it is dried up, stale, or brought from a distant country. One should consider neither time nor place.
Gauranga Prabhu was telling, Bhattacharya quoted this sloka and he took the prasad. For us, we don't need the sloka also. Without that also, I can take it. Isn't it? Whether you remember the sloka or not, you will take prasad. Na desha niyamastatra na kala niyamastatha praptamannam drutam shishthair bhoktavyam harir abravit. Yeah.
The prasadam of Lord Krishna is to be eaten by a gentleman as soon as it is received. There should be no hesitation. There are no regulative principles concerning time and place. This is the order of the Supreme Personality of God.
Wonderful order, na? From Padma Purana. Dekhi anandita haila Mahaprabhu Ramana. Prema vishta haiya Prabhu kaila lingana.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very pleased to see this. He became ecstatic in love of Godhead and embraced Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
Duhi jane dari duhe kare nanartana. Prabhu bhritya duha sparshe dohara fulemana. Yeah.
The Lord and the servant embraced each other and began to dance. Simply by touching each other, they became ecstatic.
Actually, Lord also feels an equal amount of joy like the Jiva, because the Jiva has returned back to his shelter again, isn't it? Huh? And the Jiva feels great joy in contact with the Lord, with the right attitude. Huh? So, Mahaprabhu became ecstatic, Bhattacharya became ecstatic, both of them began to dance. Huh? Actually, Mahaprabhu, why is he dancing? The reason will come now. That Bhattacharya has become transformed. He is no more impersonalist. Now he is a devotee. He has understood the glory of prasadam. Which means Bhattacharya knew all these shlokas, but they were all dead shlokas for him before, because he was being an impersonalist. Now the shlokas are coming to help to glorify the Vaishnava philosophy. Correct, no? Shvedakampa ashtu duhe anande bhasila. Prema vishta haya prabhu kahite lagila. Yeah.
As they danced and embraced, spiritual symptoms manifested in their bodies. They perspired, trembled, and shed tears. And the Lord began to speak in his ecstasy.
Ajimuyi anayase jinino tribhuvana. I have easily conquered all the three worlds, he is saying. Ajimuye karino vai kunta arohana. I have gone back to Vaikuntha, Mahaprabhu is saying. Today I conquered all the three worlds and I have gone to the spiritual world. Yeah, read the purport.
The goal of human perfection is stated here in brief. One has to surpass all the planetary systems of the material universe, pierce through the covering of the universe, and reach the spiritual world, known as Vaikuntha Loka. The Vaikuntha Lokas are variegated spiritual planets situated in the Lord's impersonal bodily effulgence, known as the Brahma Jyoti. One may aspire to elevate himself to a heavenly planet within the material world, such as the moon, the sun, or Venus. But if one is spiritually advanced in Krishna consciousness, he does not wish to remain within the material universe, even in a higher planetary system. Rather, He prefers to penetrate the covering of the universe and attain the spiritual world.
Even in a verse like this, Prabhupada uses it to teach people, don't try to go to heaven, go to spiritual world. But actually, why Mahaprabhu said, I have gone to Vaikuntha today, the home of Bhattacharya has transformed into Vaikuntha. Because his consciousness is transformed into Vaikuntha. Into the fact, actually. You go to even grihastha's homes, to the degree the grihastha is very Krishna conscious, husband and wife, you will see how meticulously they decorate the Lord and the altar and what, how many bogas they offer. Like I had gone to Nagar, Raman Nagar, one home, they have Jagannath Baladi Subhadra. So much love they worship, you know. So many bogas they offer, more than chapan boga. Although the house is itself very small, but they are very eager to cook and offer with so much devotion, and they do bhajan, kirtan and everything. So the person's internal state of consciousness becomes externally manifest, correct, no? By the service. So Mahaprabhu felt that he has gone to Vaikuntha by seeing the consciousness of Bhattacharya.
Aji mora purna haila sarva bilasha. Sarva bho mera haila mahaprasade vishwasa.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu continued, I think that today all my desires have been fulfilled because I see that Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya has acquired faith in the Mahaprasadam of Lord Jagannath.
Aji tumi nishkapate haila Krishna shraya. Krishna aji nishkapate toma haila sadaya.
Indeed, today you have undoubtedly taken shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna. And Krishna, without reservation, has become very merciful toward you.
Aaji se kandila tumara dehadi bandhana. Aaji tumi chinna kaile mayara bandhana.
So your bodily bondage and Maya's bondage, everything is cut to pieces now, Bhattacharya.
Aji Krishna prapti yogya haila tomara mana. Veda dharma langhi kaile prasada bhakshana.
See, today you have become eligible to attain Krishna. Why? By the state of your mind and consciousness. Why? Because you are not stuck in the Vedic rules of, I have to take a bath, I have to wash my teeth, only then I will eat prasad, I am a brahmana. You know, So when rituals become more prominent, for brahminical rituals become more prominent, then the spontaneity of bhakti becomes choked. Nevertheless, in our life, we still follow the rules. Why? Because we cannot pretend to be in spontaneous platform in our stage, correct? No? So, therefore we follow the rules. But once a person has come to spontaneous platform, then all this kind of rituals and rules, they go to the background for such a person.
Yesham sa yesha bhagavan dayaye danantaha. Sarvatmana ashrita pado yadi nirvyalikam. Te dustaramati taranti cha deva mayam. Naisham mamahamiti dhi shvasrigala bhakshye.
Translation.
When a person takes shelter of the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead without reservation, the unlimited merciful Lord bestows His causeless mercy upon him. Thus he can pass over the insurmountable ocean of nescience. Those whose intelligence is fixed in the bodily conception, who think, I am this body, are fit food for dogs and jackals. The Supreme Lord never bestows His mercy upon such people.
Yeah, this talks about bodily consciousness and Krishna consciousness. For becoming Krishna consciousness, we have to become dehasmriti nahi. We say, no? We become free from the yasyatma buddhir kuna petri dhatu ke sadhi kalatra adishubhamajit. One has to become free from the bodily consciousness. And then completely forgetful of the external world, one should do bhakti from the heart. Otherwise, the opposite of that is bodily consciousness, which is condemned here. Yeah, because in your bodily consciousness, we cannot realize Krishna or oneself also properly. Yeah, and then he's saying Mayavadi, Sannyasi, they cannot engage in service of the Lord or expect mercy of the Lord because they go to very high and then they fall again, he says. So, karma kanda, jnana kanda, vishera banda, Papa is saying, yeah.
Yetaka hi Mahaprabhu aila nijasthane.
Sei haite Bhattacharyera kandila abhimane. Yeah.
After speaking to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya in this way, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu returned to his residence. From that day on, the Bhattacharya was free because his false pride had been dismantled.
Amazing. Chaitanya Charana Vine Nahi Jane Ana Bhakti Vinu Shastre Rara Nakare Vyakhyana. Yeah.
From that day on, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya did not know anything but the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And from that day, he could explain the revealed scriptures only in accordance with the process of devotional service.
Amazing, no? Such a transformation. Gopinatha Acharya Tara Vaishnavata Dekhiya. Hari Hari Bali Nache Hate Tali Diya. Yeah.
Seeing that Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was firmly fixed in the cult of Vaishnavism, Gopinatha Acharya, his brother-in-law, began to dance, clap his hands and chant,
Hari, 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 Hari. I like that, you clap dance. You became very joyful. So this concludes this section. So 239 onwards, you will see next class, Sarvabhauma's devotion and composition of two verses in glorification of Mahaprabhu. So that section and one more, I think in two classes it will get over, I think. Maybe one or two classes, okay? Sri Prabhupada ki, Sri Satyacharita Amrita ki, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki. Thank you very much.